Welcome to ragurkul.com. In this video, we'll discuss about how to create contract in ServiceNow. So ServiceNow is again a ticket system where enterprises are using to manage their assets, contract information, vendor detail, IT related stuff, change request, and incident. So here, this is a major application used for any enterprises to manage end-to-end their company assets related informations or ITSM. So we here will discuss about how to create a contract and activate this contract in detail. If you want to learn about ServiceNow administrations, you can watch my complete playlist of ServiceNow admin. I will include the URL in my description tab so that will be easy for you to understand and go through complete playlist. Now, if you talk about a contract is a binding agreement between two parties. In ServiceNow platform, contracts contain detailed information such as contract number, start date, end date, active status, terms and conditions, statements, documents, renewal information, and financial terms. If you want to go through or open the contract list, simply click here, enter the contract text. Once you enter the contract, you will see here all contracts are available. In contract section, it is divided into different sections like insurance, lease, maintenance, non-disclosure, purchasing agreement, purchasing order. So either you can select any of the options or click on all. So when you will click on the all, you will find it out all the contract lists are available here. If you want to create a contract, so here we can create a various contract model for lease, maintenance, and warranties. So we need to have the contract manager or admin permissions. Then only we will be able to create this field. Click on new, enter contract model. So contract model, you have to select is the contract model related information. Simply click on the search icon and select any of the field. Let's say we want to create software license. Click on this contract and you can see this model is filled. With which vendor we are purchasing, select any of the vendor like Amazon. Here I'm giving the contract number as 2221. Name, this is the test software. Now, here we have to provide the approver related detail. So I'm giving here the approver name. Then we need some detail. Let's say I'm entering here 40 euro. So in this sections, we will have the vendor detail. It means the vendor responsible for the contract. This field is required when the contract model select is an NDA or purchase agreement. Contract model, it means the model that contract is assigned to, that is lease, maintenance, warranty, and service contract. We have the commitment. So in commitment field, we are entering amount committed to spend with this vendor. So whatever amounts we are okay with it, we can, and even we can specify some discount amount and other details like vendor account, PO number, cost centers. We have to define all these things because this is a mandatory required to enter this detail so that we can use it for the tracking perspective. Current state of the contract, we might keep as draft, active, or expired, or cancel. So here, let's click on submit. Once we'll click on submit, the contract will be created successfully. If I want to search with the contract number, I will enter the exactly same number here so that I will be able to see that contract. You can see here, we have selected the Amazon vendor and test software. Now, the state of this contract is still in draft status. If we want to move it to the active, then definitely we have to enter the submit for review. Even we can see the contract histories, exactly nothing. Or even we can see the approval histories, not available anything. So for this information which is available here, we can see in detail, right? The renewal, we don't have any renewal informations. Terms and conditions, again, not there. Then we have not defined any assets covered, used covered, expense, license, and child contracts. Our motto was to create the contract. And if we want to update the contract detail, simply I will click on update, select that contract detail, enter the information. Let's say I want to update the vendor name. So instead of Amazon, I want to go ahead with the Adobe systems. What we'll do, we'll click on this informations and select this informations and click on update. This contract will be updated successfully. At any point of time, if I want to delete this contract, simply I will click on delete and it will ask for my confirmations. Once I will click on delete, this contract will be deleted successfully. And when I will search with that contract number, I won't find this contract number exists here. So this is how we can create, update, and delete contract in ServiceNow. Hope you enjoyed the content. If you think so, this will be useful. Don't forget to share within your circle. Thank you for watching.